So children, so let us practice how to write the tables by using the concept of multiplication. So let us learn how to write and how to write the tables by using multiplication, that is multiplication tables. So children, so these multiplication tables are very important. So you have to get thoroughly these multiplication tables, then only you can do the multiplication which will become in the next exercises. So all of you should learn these multiplication tables, then only you can easily do the multiplications. So now let us learn how to write the table, that is the table of 5. So let us learn how to write the table of 5. So children, see here, you are observing some balls. So in the first row, children, how many groups of balls are there? There is only one group. In the second row, there are two groups of balls. In the third row, there are three groups of balls. And in the fourth row, there are four groups of balls. So in this way, each row contains some groups of balls. So here, in first row, how many groups of balls are there? So one group of balls. And in each group, how many balls are there? Children, each group has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So each group has 5 balls. So children, total how many balls it will become? So there is only one group and each group has 5 balls. So that means 1 time 5. That is 1 time 5 is 5. This 1 time 5 can be written as 1 into 5. That is equal to 1 5 is 5. So children, see the second row. Here, how many groups of balls are there? There are two groups of balls are there. And each group has how many balls? Each group has 5 balls. That is, number of groups are 2. And each group has 5 balls. That is, total how many balls are there? Then, we have to 2 times of 5. 2 times 5, that is, you can write this 2 times of 5 into multiplication as 2 into 5. That is 2 5 jar. Children, how much? 10. So children, in this way, in the third row, there are 3 groups of balls. Each group has 5 balls. That is the total number of balls can be obtained by doing 3 times 5. 3 times 5. So that is 3 times 5 can be written as 3 into 5. That is 3 5 jar 15. So children, fourth row. So there are 4 groups of balls and each group has 5 balls. That means how many total number of balls are there? We can get the total number of balls by doing 4 times 5. So we have to add 5 4 times here to get the total number of balls. That means 4 times 5 and it can be written as 4 into 5. 4 5 jar. Children, how much it becomes? 4 5 jar 20. So if you add all these balls, you will get 20. So children, see the next row. That is, how many groups of balls are there? Total, there are 5 groups of balls. Each group has 5 balls. That is, how many balls are there total? How can we get the total number of balls? The total number of balls can be obtained 5 times 5. That means there are total 5 groups. Each group has 5 balls. That is 5 times 5. And it can be written as 5 into 5. And 5 5 jar 25. 5 5 jar 25. That means there are total 25 balls are there. So see the next row. So children, how many groups of balls are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 6 groups of balls are there. Each group has 5 balls. That means the total number of balls can be obtained by doing 6 times 5. So 6 times 5 can be written as 6 into 5. That is 6 5 jar. Children, how much? 6 5 jar? 30. So total there are 30 balls are there. So in the same way, children, there are total 7 groups of balls. Each group has 5 balls. That is the total number of balls are 7 times 5. That is 7 into 5. 7 5 jar 35. The same way, children, so there are 8 groups of balls are there. So each group has 5 balls and it can be written as 8 times 5. And 8 times 5 can be written as 8 into 5. 8 5 are 40. So that means there are total 40 balls are there. See the next one. So children, how many groups of balls are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There are total 9 groups of balls are there. Each group has 5 balls. That means 9 times 5. And it can be written as 9 into 5. That is 9 5 are 45. So children, see the next one. How many groups of balls are there? There are total 10 groups. Each group has 5 balls. It can be written as 10 times 5. That is 10 into 5. And 5 jar, children, how much? 50. And 5 jar, 50. So that means there are total 50 balls are there. So children, what is the table 5? So that is, this is the 5th table. That is 1 5 jar, 5. 2 5 jar, 10. 3 5 jar, 15. 4 5 jar, 20. 5 5 jar, 25. 6 5 jar, 30. 7 5 jar, 35. 8 5 jar, 40. 9 5 jar, 45. 10 5 jar, 50. The children, so this is the table of 5. So next, see the next table, that is the table of 6. So how can we write the table of 6? So children, what are you observing here? You are observing some leaves. So this is the first group. This is the one group of leaves. So, and there are 2 groups of leaves. And here there are 3 groups of leaves. Here 4 groups of leaves. So in this way, there are some groups of leaves in each row. And each group has how many leaves? Children, let us count how many leaves are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means 3 leaves are on left side. 3 leaves are on right side. Total, how many leaves are there? Total, there are 6 leaves. So each group has 6 leaves. So see the first one. So how many groups are there? 1 group. And there are 6 leaves in each group. That means 1 times 6. That is 1 into 6. 1 6 jar. Children, how much? 6. That means there are total 6 leaves. See the next one. How many groups are there? 2 groups of leaves are there. And each group has 6 leaves. And it can be written as 2 times 6. And 2 into 6, 2 6 jar, 12. That means there are total 12 leaves are there. See the next one, children. How many groups are there? 3 groups are there. Each group has 6 leaves. So it can be written as 3 times 6. And 3 into 6, 3 6 jar, children, how much it becomes? 18. 3 6 jar, 18. So that means there are total 18 leaves are there. See the next one. There are 4 groups and each group has 6 leaves. That means 4 times 6 and 4 into 6. 4 6 jar, children, how much it becomes? 24. 4 6 jar, 24. So children, see the next one. So how many groups are there? There are total 5 groups. Each group has 6 leaves. That is 5 times 6. And it can be written as 5 into 6. 5 6 jar. Children, how much? 5 6 jar? 30. That means total there are 30 leaves. So children, see the next one. How many groups are there? Total there are 6 groups. Each group has 6 leaves. That is 6 times 6. And it can be written as 6 into 6. 6 6 jar. Children, 36. So right, 36 here. So that means there are total 36 leaves are there. And see the next one. Children, how many groups are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 groups are there. Each group has 6 leaves. It can be written as 7 times 6. And 7 into 6. 7, 6 jar. Children, how much? 7, 6 jar? 42. So, right, 42. That means there are total 42 leaves. And see the next one. So, here there are total 8 groups are there. Each group has 6 leaves. That means 8 times 6. Can be written as 8 into 6. 8 6 jar, children, 48. So 8 6 jar, 48. That means there are total 48 leaves. So see the next one. So there are 9 groups. So each group has 6 leaves. So 9 times 6, that can be written as 9 into 6. 9 6 jar, how much? 9 6 jar? 54. So write 54 here. So that means there are total 56 leaves. So 54 leaves. So channel, see the last one. How many groups are there? So total there are 10 groups. Each group has 6 leaves. That means 10 times 6. It can be written as 10 into 6. 10 6 jar, children. So 10 6 jar, 16. So there are total 16 leaves are there. So this is the table of 6. So let us see once again. 6 1 jar 6. 6 2 jar 12. 6 3 jar 18. 6 4 jar 24. 6 5 jar 30. 6 6 jar 36. 6 7 jar 42. 6 8 jar 48. 6 9 jar 54. 6 10 jar 60. So this is the 6th table. So children, table of 7. So how to write the table of 7? So children, you are observing some sweets. So each bowl represents one group. So each group has, children, how many sweets? So each group has, that means each bowl has 7 sweets. So each bowl has 7 sweets. So here in the second row, there are 2 bowls. That means there are 2 groups. In the third row, there are 3 groups. In the fourth row, there are 4 groups. So in each group, there are 7 sweets. So here, see the first one here. How many groups are there? There is only one bowl, that is one group. So 1 times 7, because each bowl has 7 sweets. That is 1 times 7, 1 into 7, that is 1 7 jar, 7. That is total 7 sweets are there. So children, see the second row. How many groups are there? So there are 2 groups and each group has 7 sweets. It can be written as 2 times 7. That is 2 into 7. 2 7 jar 14. 2 7 jar 14. That means there are total 14 sweets are there. See the third row. So children, how many groups of sweets are there? There are 3 groups and each group has 7 sweets. It can be written as 3 times 7 and also 3 into 7. That is 3 7 jar 21. So there are total 21 sweets are there. See the next one. So there are 4 groups. Each group has 7 sweets. That is 4 times 7. It can be written as 4 into 7. That is 4 7 jar 28. So children, there are total 28 sweets are there. And see the next one. So how many groups are there here? There are total 5 groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Each group has 7 sweets. That is 5 times 7. Can be written as 5 into 7. 5, 7 jar. Children, how much? 5, 7 jar? 35. So there are total, there are 35 sweets are there. And see the next one. There are 6 groups. Each group has 7 sweets. That is 6 times 7 and it can be written as 6 into 7. 6 7 jar 42. So total there are 42 sweets are there. So children, see the next one. So how many groups are there? So there are, so 6 7 jar 42. So how many groups are there? There are 7 groups are there. Each group has 7 sweets. That means 7 times 7. That is 7 into 7. 7 7 jar 49. So total 49 sweets are there. And here, how many groups are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total there are 8 groups. Each group has 7 sweets. Can be written as 8 times 7. That is 8 into 7. So 8 7 jar 56. Total 56 sweets are there. So children, so see the next one. How many groups are there? There are total 9 groups are there. Each group has 7 sweets. So that is 9 times 7. It can be written as 9 into 7. That is 9 7 jar 63. So total there are 63 sweets. And see the next one, children. How many groups are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Total 10 groups are there. Each group has 7 sweets. It can be written as 10 times 7. And it can be written 10 into 7. That is 10, 7 jar, 70. So total there are 70 sweets. So children, this is the table of 7. So 1, 7 jar, 7. 2, 7 jar, 14. 3, 7 jar, 21. 4, 7 jar, 28. 5, 7 jar, 35. 6, 7 jar, 42. 7, 7 jar, 49. 8, 7 jar, 56. 9, 7 jar, 63. 10, 7 jar, 70. So this is the table of 7. So let us see the next table. That is table of 8. So children, so here you are.